A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke. The Lord Jesus appointed 72 disciples whom he sent ahead of him in pairs to every town and place he intended to visit. He said to them, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest. Go on your way. Behold, I am sending you like lambs among wolves. Carry no money bag, no sack, no sandals, and greet no one along the way. Into whatever house you enter, first say peace to this household. If a peaceful person lives there, your peace will rest on him. But if not, it will return to you. Stay in the same house and eat and drink what is offered to you, for the laborer deserves a payment. Do not move about from one house to another. Whatever town you enter and they welcome you, eat what is set before you. Cure the sick in it and say to them, 'The kingdom of God is at hand.'" The Gospel of the Lord. The Lord Jesus appointed 72 disciples. The number 72 is to be understood symbolically. Just like the number 12, the 12 represents the reconstitution of the 12 tribes of Israel. The 72 may allude to the 70 elders who accompany Moses up to the holy mountain of God. They share in God's spirit and are enabled to prophesy. Thus, they are disciples who are also empowered to share the mission of the 12. The Gospel pericope about the mission of the 72 anticipates the labors of missionaries. Other than the apostles, in the Acts of the Apostles, in particular, they refer to partners in mission of the Apostle Paul, Timothy, and Titus, whose feast we are celebrating today. Barnabas, Silas, Luke, the author of the third Gospel and Acts, Priscilla and Aquila, Lydia, Chloe, and others who form the Pauline circle. Following the feast of the conversion of the great apostle to the Gentiles, the celebration of his close collaborators, Timothy and Titus, shows us Paul's precious heritage. Not only those whom he brought to Christ in his letters, but also his disciples and co-workers in the Gospels.